The new season of Dancing with the Stars begins this Monday night at 8 o'clock on ABC. There is many well-known names on this season. You have Maria Menounos, you have Jaleel White, Gavin DeGraw, Jack Wagner, and Roshon Fegan, among people like Sherry Shepherd and Melissa Gilbert, and so many more, and Gladys Knight, I can't forget her. But joining me on the program is the current partner of Roshon Fegan, Chelsie Hightower. She has also been partnered with Ty Murray, Louis Vito, Jake Pavelka, Michael Bolton, and Romeo Miller in the past, and she even made it into the top six on season 4 of So You Think You Can Dance. She's also an avid fitness instructor, and she's got some behind-the-scenes information about what to expect on this season of Dancing with the Stars. Hi, Chelsie. How are you tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. So thank you for coming on the program. And we've seen you grace the stage on Dancing with the Stars and also on So You Think You Can Dance.
Yeah.
But how did you discover your passion for dancing?
You know, I was young. I was 9 years old. And it's funny because they actually, the elementary school that I was going to at the time had the only ballroom program in America at the time. And so, you know, I saw my peers doing it, and that was something that, you know, I knew I just had to do it. I had to try it out. And once I did, I was hooked, and I've never been able to stay away since.
So now, what seems to be your favorite aspect of ballroom dancing?
My favorite aspect of ballroom dancing, it's the way you express yourself. For a lot of dancers, it's the way that we get out our emotions. There's many ways to express yourself, but I feel like for me, dancing is the absolute best, and it feels amazing when you're just getting out your frustration or your sadness or even your happiness, it's a blast.
Now, watching you guys on Dancing with the Stars, you guys make it look so easy because you're that good, but what are some of the training routines that you have had to get into daily in order to be in the kind of shape that you're in for that?
For me, I'm a really healthy person, and living healthy is a huge passion of mine, and it's something that I really have to watch. You know, I wasn't really blessed with a naturally skinny body per se, and it's something that I have to work on. So eating healthy is number one, and making sure that whatever I put into my body is something that's going to fuel it and not harm it in any way. And I'm actually here to talk about OPA, to a Better You Sweepstakes, which is a sweepstakes that I have teamed up with Old London and Melba Toast, or Old London, and they're actually the makers of Melba Toast. And we're launching this sweepstakes, and we're giving a free trip to the Greek Islands today. So all you have to do is go onto Old London's Facebook page and sign up for your chance to win. But we also just want to encourage everybody to live a healthy lifestyle and make sure that you are doing doing fun and interesting things that are going to keep you interested in being healthy and interested in new things and new and exciting things that's going to keep you healthy every single day.
Now, with healthy eating, I've noticed one thing with the exit interviews a lot of times for each of the Dancing with the Stars seasons. One that
yeah.
I can think of is Chelsie Kane. She was saying she actually had to eat more because of how much she was dancing and working out.
Definitely. Obviously, if you work out more, your metabolism kind of speeds up, and so your body craves more food because it's burning a lot more. So she was eating quite a bit. I remember she was eating quite a bit. She's got a tiny little frame on her, but she was able to pack down quite a bit of food. I think it's really important to make sure that you do listen to your body and you're fueling your body constantly with good and healthy things. For me, I love Melba Toast. It's perfect for my schedule. You know, I'm constantly on the go and constantly running from A to B, and it's low calorie, low fat, and all natural. So it's a perfect little snack for me to take with me to rehearsals or wherever else.
Now, with Dancing with the Stars, how often do you guys find out who your partner actually is? Like, how soon before?
We find out a couple of days before. Not a lot of time.
Okay, because I noticed this season when they were introducing everyone, some
yeah.
people had said they'd already started rehearsing, and some people had said that they were just meeting for the first time.
Right. It's all a little bit different, depending on the celebrity and their schedule. Some celebrities are able to meet a little bit sooner, and some have to wait for a while, so it always depends.
Now, were you able to meet Roshon ahead of time, or did you meet that day?
We met that day.
Okay, and what kind of dancer have you noticed that he's becoming, since I feel like he has a little bit of dance experience already with the Disney show that he's on?
Yeah, you know, he has freestyle experience, which is great because we're able to incorporate some of the moves that he's done in the past. But at the same time, it's also a bit of a hindrance in another way, because I'm having to break that habit that he's formed over the years. You know, the posture could not be more opposite from what he does in his freestyle stuff. But yeah, it helps and it hinders. So it has two different sides to it.
So there's really no benefit over someone who doesn't have any dance experience versus someone who is skilled in a certain specialty of dance.
No, I didn't. No, there's definitely benefits to it. I didn't say that there wasn't a benefit. There's benefits to it. You know, he's able to incorporate the stuff that he does in his freestyle into our dances, which makes it more entertaining, obviously.
Now, one thing I noticed is I was a little disappointed that you weren't on last season, and I noticed Lacey Schwimmer isn't on this season.
Yeah.
So do you guys just now have that many pro dancers that you have to cycle through when some of you don't get on the season?
Yeah, you know, it all depends. Sometimes they just don't have a celebrity that matches up with you, and so you have to take a little break and take a season off. But yeah, you know, it all just kind of depends on the celebrities that they choose. So
now, how do they match you up with these celebrities? Because I notice sometimes you're paired with the younger star because you're one of the younger pro dancers, but
yeah.
Sometimes you're also paired with someone like Michael Bolton.
Right. They do it by personality and height and usually age, but you never really know. You know, the producers they do a really, really great job at matching people up, and sometimes you get the younger ones, sometimes you get the older ones, and it's all within what they feel like is going to be best for the overall dynamic of the show.
Now, when you joined your first season, were you kind of like, oh, I hope I get this person, or now is it just one of those, I'll take whoever I get?
You know, I wasn't even thinking about that my first season. It was just, you know, I was excited to be a part of the show, and I still feel the same way, just excited to be there and happy to have whoever it is that they choose to give me.
So now, I imagine there's a lot of work day-to-day because I feel like you have such a short time to teach one of these dances and sometimes even two, but how does that play into if you have to learn another dance with one of the pro dancers as well?
You know, the pro dances are one of my favorite parts about the show. We basically go in, we throw something together in about 2 hours, and we perform it on the Tuesday. So, you know, we're experienced, we're used to that kind of thing. We can throw stuff together. And that's you know, the fun stuff about the show. Well, it's all fun, but that's just one of the more fun parts, definitely.
Now, how late are you guys rehearsing some of the time when you're with, like, someone like Roshon or some of the other people you've had in the past?
It depends. It depends on their schedule. You know, we kind of have to go by the celebrity schedule. A lot of them have a million and one things going on. Roshon has his show, Shake It Up. He also does his own music stuff, so we're having to work around that. There's been several times where we haven't even started till about 8 o'clock at night, late hours and early hours of the night. Late hours of the night, early hours of the morning. So it just kind of depends on the celebrity you have.
And Chelsie, I just have one last question for you. Where can people go to find out more information about the Greek Island contest that you mentioned?
Go to Old London's Facebook page, and basically all you have to do is just go on and enter in your information, and you're entering for a chance to win a free trip to the Greek Island.
Great. Well, thank you for coming on the program, Chelsie. It was a pleasure talking with you, and I will be certain to make sure that I am tuned to ABC this Monday to watch you on Dancing with the Stars, and I will be rooting for you.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Have a great day. That was Chelsie Hightower. She is on Dancing with the Stars, and this season she's paired with Disney star Roshon Fegan. And I have a little sneak peek into Roshon and Chelsie's first rehearsal to show that personality that she was talking about that they paired her with.
What?
Yo.
What?
Yeah.
She's Ro.
Whoa.
And I'm Cho.
Help.
We're about to go on the dance floor.
So there's a little sneak peek into some of the fun that you'll see with Chelsie Hightower and Roshon Fegan on this upcoming season of Dancing with the Stars. And you can check out the season premiere this Monday night at 8 p.m. on ABC.